presentation of 10 of the finest underground.
That's the finest.
Small Press Alliance is 10 of the finest underground magazines in the Boston area. I'm a publisher of Underground 3OS magazine, which is available for $2. And the other magazines involved are American Living, Out Magazine, Oak Square, Get Stupid, False Positive, Quimby, Nightmares of Reason, and of course that infamous rag of yellow journalism, Street Magazine. And first up, we're going to introduce Jerry Rossi, who has been publishing Exit Out. And here she is, Jerry Rossi.
This is called Slow Gin and Fast Pussy. You like brunettes, you like blondes, but Dean especially liked redheads. Red as hell, redheads. He liked the way their skin was almost translucent. He liked the way they always had pretty fingers. And they had names like Suzanne and Camille and Marguerite. Names like that turned him on. But most of all, redheads knew how to please a man. They knew how to fuck. He liked fucking them in his Plymouth Fury. He liked taking them to some tourist-infested spot and fuck them in the parking lot. Like at a Celtics game. He hated basketball. He hated people who went to basketball games. But he loved to fuck redheads in his Fury in a crowded parking lot. He liked to hear 10,000 people cheer him slamming down her court. The redheads loved it too. They always came back for more. He loved to drink gin when went out looking for pussy. He liked bourbon too. He even liked bourbon better, but bourbon made him mean. So did vodka. Brunettes and blondes fell all over him when he was in bourbon mode. Gin, on the other hand, is redhead bait. He didn't know why. It just turned out that way. And it worked. He kidnapped a redhead once. He didn't have anything else to do for spring break anyway. She studied sculpture. Dean collected unemployment. So they drove to Colorado. Dean used to live in Denver, so he knew the territory. He used to be a drama and literature student in Boulder. He used to study Buddhism and poetry at the Naropa Institute. But he didn't tell anyone he knew in Boston about that. In fact, he had a mild contempt for students, especially art students. They stayed at the Royal Host on Colfax near the Capitol Building in Denver for a full week. She paid for all the lodging and alcohol. He showed her every flop house where Neil Cassidy lived in the 40s. He showed her every spot where a Clint Eastwood film was shot. He showed her every art gallery and every strip joint. The strip joints were more interesting. She showed him every orifice in her body. He made a few more. Dean got back to Boston on a Wednesday and slept till Friday afternoon. He cashed his unemployment check, paid rent on his loft, and bought a quart of gin for his liquor cabinet. The Fury was running like a charm, the bomb hadn't dropped yet, and the sunset was looking cherry red. This one I think some of you might relate to. I am scum. I stink. I like to stink. I haven't had a bath in 2 weeks. I like to sit on the subway car going nowhere in particular. I like to sit next to a pretty girl and watch her scream. She is wondering if it is too impolite to get up and move. She is suffocating from my urine and sweat perfume. I belch nice and big. She gets up and moves clear to the other side of the car. I don't even look up, but I'm laughing inside. She is a pretty girl, and I am so hideous. I am only 36, but I look 50. My face is gray from eating slop and drinking rot gut and chain smoking Lucky Strikes. My clothes don't fit. They are tight and filthy, and some of the seams are ripping. My hair has dreads in it. I live in a rooming house in Central Square. I get a disability check every month. Every month when I cash the check, I go buy devil dogs and chocolate ice cream. Then I go to Burger King and buy 3 Whoppers, 3 large fries, and 3 chocolate shakes. Then I go home and eat everything. I get bloated and groggy from all the food. I feel sick but secure. My pants won't close because my belly is full of food and gas. I feel inside and rub myself. I lean over and begin flipping in a penthouse. I get excited and rub harder. All those pretty girls and me so hideous. I come. Then I wipe myself on the sheet. I haven't washed those sheets in 3 months. They are crusty and stained. I get up and go for a walk. I can hardly walk because I'm so bloated. I get to the red line. A pretty girl sits near me. She has long black hair and eyes. She looks my way as she has just got a whiff of me. The train begins to move. I fart nice and big. She gets up.